Hello students, welcome for another session of our class 7th, chapter 8, congruency of triangles. In our previous classes, we have learned about all the criterions of congruency for the triangles, SSS, SAS, ASA, RHS, 4 congruency criterions we have learned, and exercise 1 and 2, both the exercises also completed in our previous class. Let's see exercise 3 in this class today. So along with that 4 criterions, 1 or 2 extra criterions also we are learning now. Just we will name that, what are that. So while discussing about these problems, that criterions also will come now. Let's see the first question of exercise 3. What is given here? In the following pairs of triangles, find the pairs which are congruent. Also write the criterion of congruency. Here some pairs of triangles are given. So first one I have drawn here. One triangle is ABC. In this, AB side is 6.5 cm, angle B is 70 degrees, angle C is 60 degrees. The next one more triangle is given, which is PQR. Here P, Q and R. So in this triangle the measures what are given, see PR is given 6.5 cm, angle P 70 degrees and angle Q 60 degrees is given. Whether this pair of triangles are congruent or not, if they are congruent, what is the criterion to say they are congruent? We have to write it. So let us check the parts or the measures which are given. According to them, whether they are congruent or not, if they are congruent, by what rule they are congruent, we have to say that. See, the measure of the side AB is 6.5 cm. Here also the measure of the side PR is 6.5 cm. That means one side here, the side is equal. Next, angle you see, here angle B is equal to 70 degrees, here angle C is equal to 60 degrees. And in this triangle, angle P is equal to 70 degrees, angle Q is equal to 60 degrees. So we can see all the three things which are same in both the triangles. See here, this angle and this angle, both are 70-70, that means B and P are equal. In this angle C, in this angle Q, C and Q are equal. And side, here AB, here PR is equal. So we can say these two triangles are congruent, but what is the criteria? Let's see what we name. So first of all, write the sides which are equal in triangle ABC, in triangle ABC and in triangle PQR, in triangle ABC, PQR, otherwise we can say QPR. Okay, I started here A, B, C. So I start from here, R, P, Q, R, P, Q. So the order is also important. So that is why I am writing like this. So first I will write the criteria which I am using, angle, angle, side one. Two angles and one side. The side is not included here. Okay, this side is separate. It is not included. We know ASA, in the previous class we learned the side included by the two angles. So that is why A should be in the middle, 2A should be either side of the angle. So that is called ASA congruency. But here, the side which is given here, this is not included by the two angles. So two angles and side we are going to write. So angle C corresponding to angle Q, CC and Q, right? Angle B corresponding angle is here P, so 70-70. Then side AB and R. So let's start with the angles. So I am starting from here C. Angle C is equal to angle Q. Angle Q. Both are of 60 degrees. Right. Next angle here B. So I am coming in reverse order. Okay. B is equal to angle P here. Angle P, which is again 70. Both are equal to 70 degrees. The side I am writing as AB. So AB. So PR, AB or RC you can say. R. So both are of same measurement, 6.5 cm. So angle, angle side, like, okay. So let's write it as by A, yes, this is another criteria we are naming. We learned only four criteria: SSS, SAS, SA, RHS. So this is the another criteria, just order is difference. So angle and side by AAS criteria, triangle ABC and triangle RPQ, ABC and RPQ, triangle ABC congruent to triangle RPQ. So we get set by giving this pair of triangles. Let's see the second question. What is given in the same question? The second bit. So one more pair of triangles are given. Let's see what are those. See this second bit in the first question. Like this, A B C D. It's a parallelogram, but the opposite vertices B and D is joined by a line. This is called the diagonal of the parallelogram. When a diagonal is drawn in a parallelogram, it will exactly divide the parallelogram into two congruent triangles. We know that, okay? In our previous classes only we learned. In a quadrilateral, if a diagonal is drawn, especially in a square or rectangle or in the parallelogram, if the diagonal is drawn, the diagonal will divide the parallelogram into two exact triangles equally. So exactly same. So they are congruent. So but what triangles are made here? A, B, D, C, D, B. Two triangles are made. So measures you see, here 20 degrees, here 20 degrees, here 30 degrees, here 30 degrees are given. So name the criterion to say these two triangles are congruent. So first, to name the criterion of the triangle, so what are the corresponding parts which are equal, we have to name it. So the triangle should be congruent. In triangle ABD, the order you see, I started from A, B, here 20 degrees angle, and D here, right? So next, I will start from here, C. In triangle C, D, here also 20 degrees, C, D, B, okay? Now, let us compare the angles. So first, I am going to compare the angle D here. So angle, which angle? ABD, ABD is equal to angle here CDB, CDB. See, at B here in this triangle it is 20 degrees. In the triangle ABD, at the upper portion only you have to see. Upper part, okay? Here 20 degrees. The lower part in the CDB triangle 20 degrees. So both are equal to 20 degrees. Okay? Now, the side between the two angles, you see, the side, this is the common side for both. In ABD, BD is there, in CDB also BD is there. So this line is common for both the triangles. So BD in this triangle is BD, in that triangle you name it as DB, both are same. Common side for both the triangles. So it is equal in both the triangles. Next, after that, the other angle. So here 30 degrees, ABD 20 degrees I mentioned, no? Now 30 degrees angle I am mentioning. So I will name it as ADB. ADB now. ADB. So now 30 degrees angle I will name it as CBD. 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 Which is equivalent to 30 degrees. So angle, side, angle. So by angle, side, angle, ASA criterion. So we can say the two triangles are congruent. What are the two triangles? Triangle ABD is congruent to triangle CDB. Triangle CDB. So this is how we
we can compare the sides or angles, whatever the values are available in the given picture. Utilize those things and compare them. If the order is correct, so we can say the two triangles are congruent to each other by the respective criterion, whatever the criterion is related to the figure we have to write. So in this figure, here triangle AD, ABD and triangle CDB are congruent by ASA criterion. Hope you all understood in this first bit. Two more questions also there, look at them, whether they are congruent or not. First you check, if they are congruent, what is the criterion? If they are not congruent, simply write they are not congruent. Why they are not congruent? If the corresponding parts are not equal, they will not be congruent. Okay? Just compare the pairs of the triangles and check which criterion is used there to say that triangles are congruent. Hope you all understood this. Let's move on to the second question. See the second question of exercise. Here, figure is given. In this A, B, C one triangle and again D, C, B another triangle. If you observe it carefully, this side BC is common for both the triangles. Side BC is common for both the triangles and this AC, DB both are intersecting at point O. Okay? Here in the first question, what is asked? Are triangle ABC and triangle DCB congruent? Question 1. Are they congruent? If they are congruent, what is the criterion? Let's see, check. Okay. Now, forget about the O. Here, O is not mentioned at all. So, we have to compare only triangle ABC, ABC and DCB, DC, like this. So, compare these only. In triangle ABC and here is B. Triangle ABC and triangle DCB. Let's check what is the information available in the figure. Here angles are available, side is not there. So angles, let's see. Angle, first in triangle ABC, here angle A is 30 degrees. Okay. Here angle A. In this 30 degrees, what is there? D. So angle D. So both are equal to 30 degrees. Right. Okay. Next, another angle. Here in this angle B is 50 degrees. Angle B is 50 degrees. Here also 50 degrees in angle C. That C here when is in DCB triangle. In DCB triangle. So in this and in that. So in triangle ABC we should not go for B. Because in triangle ABC B is not completed up to here only. So we should not take here B. We should take here C. Understand? Here we should take C. In triangle ABC this is a complete angle. Here it is not. This side in DBC triangle here this B. So here C this side, here B this side. That means angle C is from triangle ABC, angle B is from triangle DCB. Like we have okay. Both are 50 degrees or 50 degrees. Okay. So now these two angles are over. As you can see, the BC side is common both. For both the triangles, the base is BC only. So BC is equal to BC. It is same both the triangles. Okay. So here BC, here CB. However, so this side or this side to this side, the length is same. So which is common side? Common side is both. Common side. So angle side. So by A, yes, we can say triangle ABC congruent to, in the same order, triangle DCB. Okay, triangle ABC, triangle DC, triangle D, CB are congruent to each other by AS rule. Okay, hope you understood this one. Now second question, you see, are triangle AOB congruent to triangle DOC? Now O, triangle AOB, this part AOB, like this, this much only you have to see. You should not see the BC now. BC is not involved here. Okay. So AOB, this side. Next triangle DOC. DOC. That means this side. Like this. So the BC side, this 50 degrees angle is not at all included. Okay. These two only you have to check. But as we proved in the first question,
So these two triangles are congruent. So when the triangles are congruent, their all corresponding parts are equal. That means what you can say. So in these two triangles, the angles are already equal. Okay. But other thing is what? This side AB and this side CD, both will be equal. Why? Because already in the full triangle ABC, AB is there. In the full triangle DCB, DC is there. So already we proved these two are congruent. That means corresponding parts will be equal. So in the first question, since triangle ABC congruent to triangle DCB, congruent by CPCD. By CPCD means yesterday only I told you. Congruent corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. By CPCD, corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. When the triangles are congruent, their all corresponding parts will be equal. So ABC, ABC triangle AB and DCB triangle here DC, both are equal. By CPCD we can say AB is equal to DC or CD, whatever. So both are equal, we can say. So now we can utilize this part. So these two will come in AOB triangle also, AB will come in COD, DOC triangle also, CD will come. Okay, DOC will come. Right? Now this and these are equal. We got it because these two triangles are congruent, we got it. And one angle is there, obviously. Okay. Next, another one, what you can say? This sides will be equal. Okay. Next, one more angle we have to take. The angle here, either you can take this angle, right? Otherwise, you can say this angle. Okay. So, we can say this triangle also congruent. In triangle AOB and in triangle DOC. So what we can take here, angles, this A and D both are same. Angle A is equal to angle D, both are is equal to 30 degrees, right? Now the remaining parts, this side and this side is equal. By CPCD we got it. So AB is equal to DC, right? Next, what you can take? This angle you can take it. Otherwise, you can take this angle also. So angle ABO is equal to, when the triangles, full triangles are congruent, obviously they will be, all corresponding parts will be equal. So this angle I am taking here, I will be taking this angle. Angle ABO, angle DCO. Angle DC, angle DCO. Okay, if you don't want to make that, you can take this also, no problem. Right? AOB and COD, like that also you can take. So both are triangles are congruent. Now what is that? ASA. So by ASA, we can say triangle AOB is congruent to triangle DOC. So we can take any corresponding parts are equal. Why? Because the full triangles are congruent in the first one only we have proved. That means when the triangles are congruent, all their corresponding parts are equal. So we can take any corresponding parts. Since ABC is congruent to DCB, we have already proved in this. So in the complete triangles, all their corresponding parts will be equal. So by CPCD, corresponding parts of congruent triangles all are equal. So all parts, whichever is possible, we can take. So by that, we can take ASA. By ASA, we are writing the triangle AOB is congruent to triangle DOC. Hope you all understood. If you are able to find another criteria, you can use another criteria also, no problem, by relating this corresponding parts. Okay, any criteria which is possible there. Except RHS. Why? Because here right angle is not there at all. So we cannot use RHS. Okay. So hope you understood this. Exercise 3 consists only 2 questions. In the first bit there are 4 I explained to. In the second bit there are 2 questions. This also I explained. So hope you all understood exercise 3. It's finished now. Let us move on to the next exercise. See exercise 4, first question. Again, pairs of triangles are given. Which congruency criterion do you use in the following? Here the first bit, triangle ABC and triangle DEF. Two triangles are given. Given that AC is equal to DF. AC and DF. So these two are equal given. AB is equal to DE given. AB is equal to DE. Okay. Next, BC is equal to EF. BC is equal to EF. So I am keeping the number of lines, you see. First line, one line. So these two. And here two lines, here two lines. These two. Here three lines. That means these one line, these two sides are equal. Two lines, these two lines are equal. Here three lines, these two sides are equal. That means all the three corresponding sides are equal. So triangle ABC congruent to triangle DEF, we can say by which criterion? Here what we are comparing? All the three sides. So by yes congruency criterion. Congruency So we are comparing all the three sides. So all the three corresponding sides of both the triangles ABC and DEF are equal. So triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF by SSS congruency criteria. This is what we identified by looking at this information which is given. So these two triangles are congruent by which rule? This SSS congruency rule. That is what asked. Which congruency criterion do you use? We use SSS congruency criteria. So second thing. Here triangle PQR and triangle XYZ. These two triangles are given. Here what information we have? Given that ZX is equal to RP. ZX. Here Z and X. This. Here R. So these two sides are equal. It is given. RQ is equal to ZY. RQ. This. And ZY. This. So here this side is corresponding to this one, this side, and one more information, angle PRQ, PRQ, so here the middle one, R is in the middle, so PRQ, angle is here, okay, XYZ, so like this, XYZ, so what you can say from this, so the triangle PQR, and triangle XYZ. Here the angle XYZ, here which angle is given? Is it XYZ given or which one is given? Let's check carefully what angle is given in the text. It is given as XZY. PRQ and XZY. So Z, this is the angle actually. So we have to check properly where the angle is located. So Z is in the middle, right? So here XZY, this. So if you observe, the angle is included by these two sides. This angle is included by these two sides. So side, angle, side. So we can say triangle PQR is congruent to triangle XYZ by which congruency rule? Side, angle, side. So by yes. Side, angle, side, congruency rule. So, congruency criteria. So, like this is the position of the angle and the sides which are corresponding. We have to observe it so carefully. Hope you understood how to identify the criterions which are helping us to say the triangles are congruent. So, in the same bit, you have two more figures. So, you have to do by yourself, observe them carefully, which criterion is helpful there, and write the criterion in that cell by using the information which is given in the question. Hope you understood. Let's move on to the second question. See the next question, second one. Here two triangles are given, ART, PEN. These two triangles are given. You want to show that triangle ART congruent to triangle PEN. Have to show these two are congruent. If you have to use SSS congruency, S S S side 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 convex. See, then you need to show what? If you want to use this congruency rule to show these two triangles are congruent, what you need to have? Here options are given. AR should be equal to what? In the triangle ART, AR should be equal to what in the triangle PEN? AR corresponding to what? PE. So we have to write here PE. Okay. Next RT. RT in this triangle, so it should be equal to what? ER. ER. Okay. Next AT. AT should be equal to PN. PN. So then we can say by SSS congruency, triangle ART is congruent to triangle PEN, you can say. So in order to use SSS congruency, AR should be equal to PE, RT should be equal to EN, AD should be equal to PN. This is how you have to fill up this. Next, second question also given. If it is given that angle T is equal to angle N, angle T is your angle N is here. If these two angles are equal, and you have to use SAS congruency. You have to use SAS, side angle side. That means this angle should be included by these two sides. This angle should be included by these two sides. So you need to show, you need to have what? RT. RT in this triangle. It should be equal to EN. It should be equal to EN. Next, PN in this triangle, it should be equal to AB. Then only we can say, so by these two sides, this angle will form the angle included by these two sides, angle included by these two sides. So this side should be equal to this side should be equal to this side. These angles are equal, it is given in the question itself. We have to use SAS. So SAS, side angle side. So this is what we need to write. RT should be equal to EN and PN should be equal to AB. Now see the third question. If it is like that, AD is equal to PN. AD is equal to PN. This one. AD is equal to PN. And you have to use ASA. ASA. Angle, side, angle. That means side should be included by the two angles. So this side should be included by the two angles. These two angles, here one angle and here one angle. That means A and D. So here another one is what given? PN. So here PN and EN. Okay. This, which two sides, which two angles we should write here? These two angles. To say AD is equal to PN, already given AD is equal to PN. This side is included by these two angles. That means here this side is included by these two angles. So angle A should be equal to angle B, angle A should be equal to angle B, and angle T should be equal to angle N, angle T should be equal to angle N. Then only you can say angle side angle T and angle N. So to use ASA along with this information, we need to have this. To use SAS along with this information, we need to have these two. To use SSS, we should have this. Hope you all understood the relations, the criteria is actually SSS, SAS, ASA. To use this criteria to say the triangles ART and PEN congruent, we should have these all information. Hope you understood this question. So let's see the next question. See question number 3. Figure is given. In this figure, you see this line AM is common for both the triangles AMP and AMQ. Either side of this line, two triangles are formed. So A and M is a common thing for both the triangles. So you have to show that triangle AMP congruent to triangle AMQ. In the proof, supply the missing reasons. Already proof has done. So to say this, what is the reason? You have to mention the reason. Here what is given? PM is equal to QM. So PM is equal to QM. So what are these in the two triangles? These are sides. Okay? Side. Okay? Next, angle PMA congruent to angle QMA. Angle PMA, this angle, QMA, this. So this is angle, okay? Angle, side, angle. Then AF is AM. It's a common side, both AF for this and AM for this also. It's a common side, okay? Common side. Equal sides, equal angle. Here it is given symbol, equal sides. So equal sides, we can write equal sides, equal sides. Here this common given, exactly equal angles. You can write equal angles, equal angles, right? This is common side, AM is common for both. So here triangle AMP congruent to triangle AMQ already given. What is the criterion to say? Here you see angle is in between the sides. So here this is the side, it is common for both. Side and his side. Side and inside. So what is the criterion helpful here? Side, angle, side criterion. So these are the reasons to say triangle AMP is congruent to triangle AMQ. Hope you all understood this. Already group has done. To write these two sides are equal. Why? This is the reason. Already the symbolically it is given. PM is equal to MQ. Their angles, these are congruent, it is given, the congruent symbol, that means exactly equal. So equal angles. And AM is equal to AM, which is a common side for both the triangles. So and side, angle, side, SAS criterion. By help of this criterion, you can say these two triangles are congruent. Hope you all understood. With this, we will conclude our class today. Let us continue the next questions in the coming up class. Hope you all understood today's class. All criterions you have to remember and make the relation among the triangles to say the triangles are congruent. Hope you all understood today. Thank you very much.